I got a call to remove some bees from my loft space. The house is a typical 1930s semi-detached, but with a loft conversion. It's a complicated layout in the loft. The homeowners know where the bees are because it's their bedroom, and they can hear them at night. They find the noise of the hive comforting. The first job is to lay absorbent dust sheets. With a Stanley knife, I cut an exploratory hole. The second exploratory hole finds the bees. I guess that the bees are living in the space between the rafters that form the edges of the windows. I'm right. I drop Lucky with the top edge. I drop straight down onto the cross member that finds the upper edge of the hive. I cut out the insulation to reveal the honeycomb that makes up the hive, and there's loads of it. Start with the honey on the left and work towards the right where most of the bees are. The bees are gentle and cooperative. I remove the combs one at a time, hoovering up the bees as I go. I couldn't fathom why there were still bees coming out of the colony, and then I found that they'd made some extra comb behind the sarking felt, so I removed that comb too, and the bees with it. Firstly, I have to admit to a schoolboy error. I left the radio on in your truck, so instead of nice bees humming, with Radio 4 going on about the state of the world. The first job was to set up a ramp into the hive, then tip the bees out of the bee vac and onto the ramp. They just need a bit of encouragement to start them moving up towards their new hive. If you look closely, see the bees walking up to the hive entrance. They always walk upwards. More encouragement. Now we're sweeping the bees off the feeder so they don't get trapped. Top up the feeder with a litre of sugar syrup. tidy away the bee vac. Strap up the hive without squishing any bees. Going to need a bigger box. So I've got a new hive in position with some frames with the honey we saved out of it when we moved it from the roof space. Should have lots of food for the winter. And the bees are feeding on the honey, which is really good. They're really still very calm as well, so that's good too. I'll move all the other frames over now because I'm going to try and find the queen. So we've seen the queen, so that's a great thing. There's no brood in this colony. It's early days yet. I might get some with all this feed I'm putting on. We've got tons of food in here. These little strips are anti-varroa strips, so these have a miticide on them. So these should be nice and clean of mites for next year. It'll help them thrive and survive. So I'll just put the box back together. So crown board. Big feeder. Just making sure it's over the hole. It's over the hole. And we'll fill that up in a minute.